We want to perform the following conversions using the metric system. The nice thing about the metric system is it's base 10, so it makes conversions very convenient. The basic unit of measure for length in the metric system is the meter, volume, it's the liter, and weight, it's the gram. And then from the basic unit of measure, we have these prefixes that represent different amounts of the basic unit. For example, a kilometer is 1,000 meters, a kiloliter is 1,000 liters, and a kilogram is 1,000 grams. Versus a millimeter is 1,000th of a meter, milliliter is 1,000th of a liter, and milligram is 1,000th of a gram. And we have several other prefixes that represent different amounts of the basic unit. For the first example, we want to convert 4 meters to centimeters. Looking at our chart here, we can see that a centimeter is 1/100th of a meter, which means one way to convert from meters to centimeters is to multiply by 100. But one of the most convenient things about having this chart is, if you can identify the column of the units that you have and the column of the units that you want to convert to, you can just count the number of columns and move your decimal that number of places in the same direction. What I mean by that is if we're here at meters and we want to convert to centimeters, we want to change the units from here to here, which is 2 columns to the right. So we can just take the number 4 with the decimal place here and move the decimal point 2 places to the right. 1, 2, which would make 4 meters equal to 400 centimeters. In the next example, we want to convert 2.5 millimeters to meters. So millimeters would be in this column here with the prefix milli. We want to convert this back to the basic unit of measure, meter. And since a millimeter is 1,000th of a meter, we could just divide by 1,000, or by counting the number of columns we're moving from here, 1, 2, 3 columns to the left. So we can take 2.5 and move the decimal to the left 3 places. So we'd have 1, 2, 3. We have to add a couple zeros here. So 2.5 millimeters is equal to 0.0025 meters. And sometimes you'll see textbooks put a zero here in the ones column. Let's go and take a look at 2 more of these. We want to convert milliliters to kiloliters. So we're in this column here for milliliters, and we want to convert all the way to kiloliters. So we can just take our decimal point and move it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 places to the left. So if we start with 250 with the decimal point here, now we'll move the decimal point to the left 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we'll have to add 3 extra zeros. 1, 2, 3, making 250 milliliters equal to 0.00025, and we can leave off this last zero. Remember, any extra zeros to the right of this last digit would not change the value of the decimal. And again, we may want to put a zero here in the ones place value. And for the last example, we want to convert 1.25 kilograms, that would be this column here, to the basic unit of grams here in the middle. So the shortcut would be to move the decimal point 1, 2, 3 places to the right. Or we could also just multiply by 1,000. So we have 1.25, move the decimal point to the right 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So we'd have 1,250 grams. And just in case you're not familiar with these abbreviations, I'll leave you with this table here that shows all the abbreviations for meters, liters, and grams.